Welcome to our Healthy Food and Healthy Life channel. Today's topic is coffee. Consuming coffee is good or bad? The health effects of coffee are controversial. There are plenty of good things to be said about coffee. It's high in antioxidants and linked to a reduced risk of many diseases. However, it also contains caffeine, a stimulant that can cause problems in some people and disrupt sleep. This video takes a detailed look at coffee and its health effects, looking at both the positives and negatives. Why is coffee good for you? Coffee isn't just tasty and energizing, it may also be extremely good for you. Coffee contains some essential nutrients and is extremely high in antioxidants. Coffee is loaded with nutrients and antioxidants. Coffee isn't just black water. Many of the nutrients in the coffee beans do make it into the final drink, which actually contains a decent amount of vitamins and minerals. One cup of coffee contains coffee is rich in many of the nutrients naturally found in coffee beans. A typical 8-ounce, 240 ml, cup of coffee contains vitamin B2, vitamin B5, vitamin B1, vitamin B3, manganese, potassium, magnesium, phosphorus. This may not seem like a lot, but try multiplying it with the number of cups you drink per day. It can add up to a significant portion of your daily nutrient intake. That said, coffee can have important beneficial effects on health for the average person. If you don't already drink coffee, these benefits are not a compelling reason to start doing it. Coffee can help you burn fat and improves physical performance. Caffeine, partly due to its stimulant effect on the central nervous system, both raises metabolism and increases the oxidation of fatty acids. It can also improve athletic performance in several ways, including by mobilizing fatty acids from the fat tissues. Coffee contains caffeine, a stimulant that can enhance brain function and boost metabolism. Caffeine is a known stimulant. In your brain, it blocks the function of an inhibitory neurotransmitter, brain hormone, called adenosine. By blocking adenosine, caffeine increases activity in your brain and releases other neurotransmitters like norepinephrine and dopamine. This reduces tiredness and makes you feel more alert. Caffeine can also boost metabolism by 3 to 11%. However, some of these effects are likely short-term. If you drink coffee every day, you will build up a tolerance and with it, the effects will be less powerful. The main active compound in coffee is the stimulant caffeine. It can cause a short-term boost in energy levels, brain function, metabolic rate, and exercise performance. Coffee may protect your brain from Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Coffee drinkers have a much lower risk of type 2 diabetes. Coffee drinkers have a lower risk of liver diseases. Coffee drinkers have a significantly lower risk of cirrhosis and liver cancer. The more coffee you drink, the lower your risk. Coffee drinkers have a much lower risk of depression. Depression is the world's most common mental disorder and leads to a significantly reduced quality of life. Negative effect of drinking coffee? Some people, especially pregnant women, should definitely avoid or severely limit coffee consumption. The truth is, there are some negative aspects to coffee as well, although this depends on the individual. Consuming too much caffeine can lead to jitteriness, anxiety, heart palpitations, and even exacerbated panic attacks. Another unwanted side effect is that it can disrupt sleep. If coffee reduces your sleep quality, try quitting coffee late in the day, such as after 2 p.m. Caffeine can also have diuretic and blood pressure raising effects, though these usually dissipate with regular use. However, a slight increase in blood pressure of 1 to 2 mmHg may persist. Caffeine is addictive. Another issue with caffeine is that it can lead to addiction. When people consume caffeine regularly, they become tolerant to it. When people abstain from caffeine, they get withdrawal symptoms, such as headaches, exhaustion, brain fog, and irritability. This can last for a few days. If you are sensitive to caffeine and tend to become overstimulated, you may want to avoid coffee altogether. How to maximize the health benefits? There are some things you can do to maximize the beneficial health effects of coffee. The most important is to not add a lot of sugar to it. Another technique is to brew coffee with a paper filter. Unfiltered coffee contains cafestol, a substance that can increase cholesterol levels. Some coffee drinks at cafes and franchises contain hundreds of calories and a lot of sugar. These drinks are unhealthy if consumed regularly. For more updates and health-related videos, click the subscribe button, share, and comment our videos.